A very good morning, student. Hope you all are fine and safe also. So welcome to my class. So this is our second class of our economic application. In our last class, so whatever we have discussed, I'll just go through the recap also, and after that we'll continue with the today's syllabus. So in our last class, we have discussed about the demand, meaning of demand, and types of demand, as well as the determinants of demand. Today, we'll be discussing about the law of demand. Law of demand, exceptions to the law of demand, as well as demand curve, as well as demand schedule. So these all things we'll be discussing in our today's class. So let me go to a recap. So in the types of demand, so what we have studied in the types of demand, we have studied about the individual demand, market demand, joint demand, composite demand, as well as derived demand. So these all we have studied, and we have studied about the determinants. What are the necessary items? What are the things which leads to the demand? Okay, the causes of demand. Like some of those are like income of the consumer, taste and preference of the consumer, price of the related goods and all. Okay, price of the commodity. So these all we have discussed. Means the demand and the commodity, demand and the price of the commodity, the demand and the price of the commodity, they have inverse relation. They don't have direct relation, they have inverse relation. Like when the price of any commodity increases, the demand for that commodity will decrease, and if the price of the commodity decreases, the demand for that commodity will be high, means increase. So they have an inverse relation. Okay, so let us continue with today's syllabus. So today we will be discussing about law of demand, and we will be discussing about the individual demand curve, schedule, as well as market demand curve and schedule, as well as, and we will be discussing about the exceptions to the law of demand. So let us come to law of demand. What is law of demand? See here, it states that other things remaining equal, other things will remain equal, the quantity demanded of a commodity increases when its price falls and decreases when the price rises. Understood? So it is related with the price of the commodity. So we have studied the determinants of the demand. There are several determinants of the demand. Okay, but here we will take just the price. If the price fluctuates, then the demand for the commodity will also fluctuate. We will not see the other factors like the taste and preference and all, income of the consumer, price of the related goods and all. We will not see these all items. Just we will be focusing on the price. See, other things remaining equal means other thing remains constant. It remains constant. It doesn't change. When the price of the commodity changes, varies, okay, then the demand for the commodity also changes. Means when the price increase, demand decrease. When the price decrease, demand increase. So this is the law of demand. Okay, this is the law of demand. Other things remaining equal, this you should write. This is the main thing. The quantity demanded of a commodity increases when its price falls and decreases when the price rises. Okay, next come to our demand schedule. What is demand schedule? It is a numerical table. It is a numerical table. Means numbers are there. Okay? Numerics are there. Numbers are there. Numerical tables. That shows different quantities of a commodity. That shows different quantities of a commodity that would be demanded at different prices during a given period of time. During a given period of time. When all other factors affecting the demand remain constant. Here also, price is the main factor and all other factors, it remain constant. Okay? See, I draw the chart also, table, this is, if this is where the table is. See, when the price is 100, the quantity demand is 1, 90, 2, 80, 3, 70, 4, 60, 5. Means, when the price decreases, the quantity demand is increases. Okay, here, okay, from bigger it comes to smaller, and from smaller it comes to the bigger unit. Okay, ascending and descending. So this is the effect of the demand when the price fluctuates. So demand schedule is divided into two categories here: individual and market demand schedule. Individual and market demand schedules here. Just if you are learning this, means you can write this both. If you are learning, then you can write two. See, so you have to be very focused. If you are understanding this, then additionally you are getting individual and market. Just a slight change you to make. I'll say you. Individual demand schedule. Here, it is a tabular statement. It is a tabular statement. Okay, it is a tabular statement. Which tabular means a table. Tabular statement that shows different quantities of a commodity that an individual would demand at different prices during a given period of time when all other factors affecting demand are held constant. That much only. Okay, here. Okay. That an individual will add instead of, okay, here for individual demand schedule and market demand schedule. Same way, it is a tabular statement that shows different quantities of a commodity that all the consumers, okay, all the consumers here, an individual consumer, and in market, that all the consumer would be demanded at different prices during a given period of time when all other factors affecting demand are held constant. This much. Okay, in here individual you add here individual, and when you're writing market demand schedule you'll add all the consumers. Next come to demand curve. Okay, see, it is the picturization of the demand schedule. Okay, it is the picturization of the demand schedule. See, demand schedule, you can see. So by seeing the demand schedule, when we construct the curve, it is called, okay, the demand schedule. So we will make a picture of this here. Just here, it is the curve showing different quantities of commodities. Different quantities of commodities here. Different quantities. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are the quantities of commodities. Okay. Demanded at various alternative prices. Demanded at various alternative prices. Different prices. Alternative means different prices. Demanded during a given time period when all other factors affecting demand are held constant. See, just the price is changed. The taste and all, it is not changed. It is constant. Just when the price is changing, so the unit is also changing. Okay. Let me show you with the help of table. See here. When the price is 100, see here. The demand is 1. Price is 100. Demand is 1. We'll meet here. When the price is 90, demand is 2. Price is 90, demand is 2. So we'll meet here. When the price is 80, demand is 3. $74. 65. Sir. Means demand curve is always downward sloping. It slopes towards the down level. Why? Because it has inverse relation between the price and the quantity of the commodities. Okay, so let's come to our next topic. Exceptions to the law of demand. See, sometimes the law of demand doesn't work with some of the theory. As the law of demand states that, okay, when the price of the commodity increases, the demand for the commodity decreases. This is the law of demand, it states. But sometimes it doesn't work. Okay. Means it goes against the concept of law of demand. So when the thing goes against the concept of law of demand, it is called exceptions of law of demand. Exceptions to the law of demand. See here. Conspicuous consumption. This is the first one. Conspicuous consumption. Try to understand. Conspicuous consumption. Consumption means to consume. See, when the particular type of person is there, when a particular type of person who lives in the society, okay, with the increase in the price, with the increase in that particular price, they will purchase more of the commodity. Increase in the price of the commodity, they will purchase more of that particular commodity. Mostly all the very expensive item. Very expensive item. When the price of the gold or diamond increases in the market, that particular type of person, they will purchase more of that commodity. Why? Because they want to show off in the society. Yes, I belong to the richest section of the society. I doesn't belong from the particular poor class or the middle class. So I belong from the richer class of the society or the family. So I will be purchasing more of the commodity so that nobody can compare with me. Nobody can come in my level. So to show off in the society, okay, the particular kind of people, when they purchase more of the commodity with an increase in the price, okay, just to show off in the society. The example is purchasing of the very expensive item like diamond or gold. Okay, it is called conspicuous consumption. Next is a bandwagon effect. Taste and preferences. Okay, both are interrelated. Conspicuous and bandwagon, they are interrelated. Okay, so let me continue here. So when the taste and preference of the particular kind of people changes, they demand for that commodity whose price increases in the market. Okay, like example, golf. Playing golf within the businessman is a prestigious matter. Means to keep the reputation in the business, they play the golf. So with the increase in the golf ball, when the demand, okay, also increases, with the increase in the price of the golf ball, when the demand for that golf ball also increases. Why? Okay. Why? Because, okay, they will show that they belong from the reputed businessman. Okay, when the increase in the golf ball, okay, the demand for the golf ball also increases. Means the people, they will purchase more of the golf ball when the price increases. okay, just to show up that they belong from the successful businessman, reputed businessman. They hold a particular position in the business, just to show up, okay, in the business field. It is called as, okay, bandwagon effect. Next, insignificant share in consumer's budget. Insignificant sales in consumer's budget. See, some of the items, some of the things, okay, some of the things which the consumers purchase, whatever the price may increase, the demand, okay, for the commodity will remain constant. Okay, even the price increase high, the demand will remain that much only. If the price will go down below, the demand for that particular commodity will remain constant only. Okay, it will not change. Okay, like example, salt. Salt is the best example for this. Next, Veblen effect. Okay, Veblen effect. So, some of the people are with the mentality that if the price of the commodity is high, the quality is also high. Okay, means they decide that price of the commodity is the true indicator of the quality. With the increase in the price, means the quality is also better. If the price of the good is less, means the quality is not so good. So this kind of consumer, with the increase in the price, okay, they purchase more of the commodity because of its quality. With price increase, quality good, they demand more of the commodity. Okay, if same product, if the price decreases, if the price decreases, that particular consumer, they are not going to purchase. Means they are with the motive, yes, they have made the mind, the price decreases, the quality is not so nice. So they will jump to other product, means more expensive good they will go through. So it is termed as Veblen effect. And next, Giffen effect. Giffen effect means it goes with the inferior goods. Inferior goods. Inferior good means little bit low quality goods. Means when the price of the commodity, the inferior goods, increases, the demand, okay, for that particular commodity also goes high. Okay, when the price of the inferior good increases, the demand, means low quality goods, when the price increases, the demand is also increases. Actually, it is when you talk about low demand, when the price increases, okay, with the inferior, the people not purchase. But here, when the price of the inferior good increases, people are going more with that commodity. Example, it happened in Ireland in 19th century. Ireland in 19th century. Okay, particularly the poor class people, they used to consume the potato with a small amount of meat with it. Potato with small amount of meat. So when the price of the potato increased, potato is the inferior good. That time potato was the inferior good. So when the price of the potato increased, so what they did? So they cut off or they decreased the consumption of meat and they consume more of potato. Means the demand, they demanded more of potato and they decreased or they cut off the consumption of meat just to meet the minimum requirement. Okay, this is what is a Giffen effect. Means it goes with inferior item. When the goods, when the price of the inferior good increases, the demand for that particular commodity also increases. So it happened in Ireland in 19th century. Means the, when the price of the potato increased, okay, the people demanded more of potato by cutting or decreasing the consumption of meat. Okay, why? Just to fill up the stomach. okay, just to get the minimum requirement. Okay, it is called as Giffen effect. So movement and shift of the demand, okay, demand curve, supply, we will study in next chapter. So movement and shift, okay, of the demand curve. So movement and shift of the demand curve, okay, will study in our next class. And in our next class, I will be giving you the question answers for this chapter also. Okay, hope you have understood whatever is being taught, okay, and go through it, be at home and be safe. Thank you.